Take this question. We are discussing about maxima and minima of a function of two variables. Now see, when you are given a function of two variables like this, just try to recall the procedure. We'll just take the actual function as it is. And then the first step here is to find out what you call stationary points. So to find out the stationary points, we need to differentiate f with respect to x and then with respect to y also. Now, after getting these two derivatives, to find out the stationary points, we equate these two derivatives to zeros. And then by solving these two equations together, we get several pairs of values for x and y, right? Then at each pair of value, we just try to evaluate what you call second order derivatives. You know, we just take these second order derivatives, 2 square f by 2x square, we call it as L. Then, you know, if you take the other second order derivative, dou square f by dou x dou y, we normally take it as m. And you see the third second order derivative is this, dou square f by dou y square, and normally we take it as n. Then see, at each stationary point, we just try to evaluate these three, and then we'll just try to verify all these conditions. When ln minus m square is greater than zero, and even l is also greater than zero, right? See, we say this function attains its minimum at that stationary point. Let us say if one stationary point is a comma b, and if, for example, if this condition is satisfied at this stationary point, then at this stationary point we can say the function attains its minimum. And in a case at a stationary point, if this condition is got satisfied, ln minus m square is greater than zero but l is less than zero, in this case you can say at that stationary point your function attains its maximum, right? So in other cases, when ln minus m square is less than zero, you can say there is no minimum, no maximum at that stationary point. And further, you can say the stationary point is a saddle point. And in case if ln minus m square itself is zero, then say you can simply say there is no, we cannot say even whether there is minimum or maximum, or we cannot speak anything about minimum or maximum. And simply you conclude further investigation is needed to speak about minimum or maximum at this stationary point, right? So we'll simply say further investigation is required. Now see, keeping all this procedure in view, let us just try to find the maximum and minimum of this particular function. Right, see, I'm just proceeding like this. I'm just considering the function what you're given in the question. You are given f of xy is equals to x cube y square multiplied by 1 minus x minus y. Right? So this function as it is. Now, see, I'm just trying to differentiate this with respect to x. Now see, when you differentiate f with respect to x, see what happens. I'm just doing it like this, you see. When we differentiate it with respect to x, we normally treat y as a constant. So I can write this y square aside. It's a constant. Then, you know, keeping this aside, now it is just like x cube into 1 minus x minus y. It's a product of two different functions, you see. So we need to use what you call UV rule. So what UV rule says is differentiation of UV is equals to, we write it like this, UV dash plus V U dash, correct? So using this simple formula, I'm writing X cube as it is, but I'm differentiating this. How much it is, you see, 1 minus X minus Y, and you're differentiating only with respect to X. So when you differentiate this term, it is minus 1, and for other two terms, you know, the derivative is 0 as they're constants, right? Plus, now see, VU dash, I'm keeping this bracket as it is, 1 minus x minus y. Then see what remains here is x cube. When you differentiate x cube, we'll get it as 3x square. Right? Now see, I'm just trying to simplify this. It is equals to y square times minus x cube. And see, if I multiply these three with this 3x square, 1 into this 3x square, then minus x into this, minus 3x cube minus this 3x square y. Then it is equals to y square times, see, you can just add these two, you see, minus x cube and minus 3x cube. minus 4x cube, then plus 3x square, then the last term, minus 3x square y. Look at these three terms. Look at these three terms. We can take one x square common from all these three terms, you see, right? We can take x square common from them so that we will get it like this. X square y square multiplied by, see, it is minus 4x. When I take x square common from all this, minus 4x plus 3 minus 3y. Now see, this is dou f by dou x. In a very similar way, let me now differentiate f with respect to y. See, I'm just trying here. Dou f by dou y is equals to, and now when we differentiate it with respect to y, as we know, x cube is a constant, correct? X is a constant actually. So when x is a constant, even x cube is also a constant. So I'm just keeping it aside. And then the remaining are these two, y square and this function, which is in brackets. Now see, again, we proceed with what you call UV rule, right? What is UV rule? I'm now first keeping y square as it is. Then when we differentiate, you know, these three terms in bracket, we get it as minus one, right? For one and minus x, the derivatives are zeros. But for minus y, the derivative is minus one. Next, plus, now see, I'm keeping this bracket as it is, one minus x minus y. And what remains there is y square. So when you differentiate y square, you know, we get it as 2y. Correct? Then it is equals to, I'm writing this x cube as it is. I'm just simplifying all these terms. So we get first minus y square, then 1 into 2y, it is 2y. Then minus x into 2y, it is minus 2xy. Then minus y into this, minus 2y square. So I'm just adding all the terms here. Already here is an x cube, I'm writing it as it is. Then x cube times, see here it is minus y square and here it is minus 2y square. When we add them, we get minus 3y square, then plus 2y minus 2xy. All right, now see again here also, if you look at these three terms, we can take a y common from these three terms. So this implies, see, here is x cube already, and now I'm taking a y common from them. So x cube y times, you know, what remains? Minus 3y plus 2 minus 2x. Right? Now, see, we got both dou f by dou x and dou f by dou y. Now, see, what is our next step? We need to equate these two to zeros. Now, see, I'm just equating dou f by dou x to zero. Now, see what happens when you equate dou f by dou x to zero, we get these things. X square y square multiplied by minus 4x minus 3y plus 3 product is equals to zero, right? Also from here, when you equate dou f by dou y to zero, see what happens to this dou f by dou y, and we are equating this to zero. This implies here it is x cube y multiplied by minus 2x. See, I'm writing the x term first, then minus 3y plus lastly constant is equals to zero. Right? Now see, we got two different equations. Look at this carefully. We need to take every possible point for both x and y from these two equations. Right? For example, while solving these equations, you cannot simply take only this term. You cannot simply take only this term from the first equation and only this term from the second equation. You need to even consider other options, because we need to calculate all possible stationary points. Then only we can identify whether we get minimum or not at that stationary point. Okay, so we need to take, as we need to take every stationary point from these set of equations. I'm just writing it this way, you see. This implies, now when this product is zero, either of these three, either x square may be zero, or y square may be zero, or, you know, this function which is in brackets may be zero. Any one of them may be zero, you know, to become this product as a zero, isn't it? So as that is the story, when x square is zero, I can write x is equals to zero. Right? When y square is zero, I can write y is equals to zero. Then from this, we can write 4x plus 3y minus 3 is equals to 0. Right? I just took a minus common from these terms. Right? When this product is 0, either of these three, if you want more clearly, I can add or. Either of these three may be 0. Similarly, from this, here also, you know, the product is 0 here. So to become this product as a 0, either x may be 0 or y may be 0 or, you know, this function which is in brackets. 2x plus 3y minus 2 is equals to 0. Right? Now we got different combinations from these two equations individually. Now see what we do to find out the combinations. Now we need to find out a point x comma y, may not be only one, but maybe more also. We need to find all possible combinations of x and y such that, you know, each combination satisfies both the equations simultaneously, right? Both dou f by dou x and dou f by dou y must be 0. To get such a stationary points, what we do, you remember this way. To get such stationary points, for example, we take one value for x from this equation. We need to get its equivalent value for y from the second equation. I repeat, to get each suitable combination x comma y. For example, if you take x from this first equation, you need to choose an equivalent y value from the second equation, right? So for example, when you take x is equal to 0, you may take either y is equal to 0 or you can substitute x is equal to 0 in this equation, right? If not x is equal to 0, you may choose y is equal to 0. For example, if you choose y is equal to 0 from the first equation, equivalent to this, either you can choose x is equal to 0 or you can substitute y is equal to 0 in this equation. Like this, corresponding to each quantity in this first set, we need to choose an equivalent value from this second set. Okay, always in the pair x comma y, we choose x from one set and y from the other set. That's a story simply. Now see, to get all possible such combinations, I'm just proceeding like this. Let me give some numbers to these two sets. This is the first set, and then let me take this as the second set. Right? And see, I'm just writing all these combinations for reference here. X is equal to 0, y is equal to 0, then 4x plus 3y minus 3 is equal to 0. So this is the first set what we considered. Then the second set, see what we got. X is equal to 0, y is equal to 0. And see the next equation, it is 2x plus 3y minus 2. Right, now see how I'm proceeding. Now see, in equation 1, when x is equals to 0, understand, I'm just taking this x is equal to 0 from the first set. Then my idea is to get an equivalent y value from the second equation. When I take x is equals to 0, from equation 2, I'm selecting the value of y. Either y may be 0 or, see, I'm just substituting x is equal to 0 in this equation, right? In this equation, 2x plus 3y minus 2. So there, when I substitute x is equal to 0, what happens, you see? 0 plus 3y minus 2 is equals to 0. So this implies, how can you write the value of y? So this implies either y may be 0 or y may be 2 by 3, right? When you send it to the other side, it becomes 2 by 3, right? Understand, when x is 0, y may be either 0 or y may be 2 by 3 also. So understand, I'm just writing it aside for reference. Later we can use this. When x is 0, its corresponding value of y may be either 0 or, you know, 0 comma, when x is 0, it may be 2 by 3 also. So this is one set of combinations for stationary points. Okay, now let me take the other values as well. In equation 1, see, we started with x is equal to 0. If not x is equal to 0, even we can take y is equal to 0, isn't it? So now I'm taking y is equal to 0. when y is equals to zero. Now, corresponding to that y is equal to zero from second equation, either I can take x is equal to zero. So that is one possibility. Or when I substitute y is equal to zero in this equation, I cannot take again y is equal to zero, right? Already we took y is equal to zero from the first set. Again, how can you choose a y value? That is all meaningless. So we just ignore this. And we here we substitute y is equal to zero. When we substitute y is equal to zero in that, we get like this 2x plus 0 minus 2 is equal to 0. So this implies we will get either x is equal to 0 or we get, see, it is 2x is equal to 2. So x is equals to 1. So what are the next set of points you see? When y is 0, x is 0. Again, you will get the same 0, 0. Next, when y is 0, x is 1. So it is 1, 0. Right? That is another combination. Now let's take, now let me take from second set, right? In equation one, this time let us take equation two. In equation two, when x is equals to zero, right? If I take x is equal to zero from this equation, second equation, when x is equal to zero, now from first equation, equation one, see, corresponding to this x is equal to zero from the second set, either we can choose y is equal to zero. That is one option. Or we can take x is equal to zero in this equation. When we substitute x is equal to zero in this equation, what happens? You see, zero plus 3y minus 3 is equal to zero. This implies when x is zero, either y may be zero or y may be, you know, if you send it to the other side, it becomes 3y is equal to 3. And therefore, you can say the value of y as 1. Now, from this, you can say when x is 0, y may be 0 already, right? You got it already. So, even if not this, when x is 0, y may be 1 also, right? You got this combination from, you know, that way. Next, if I take the other one, let me just write it here. See, what is the next one? In the same equation two, when y is zero. Now see, if I take y is equals to zero, what happens? You see, now from equation one, see, now I'm taking y is equals to zero. When y is zero, I can take either x is equals to zero. If not this, I can directly substitute the value of y is equal to zero in this equation. So when I do so, what happens? You see, 4x plus 0 minus 3 is equals to 0. So that implies we get either x is equal to 0 or, you know, what it is, 4x is equals to 3. So it be x becomes 3 by 4. So what combination here you got? You see, either it is 0, 0, or you see it is 0, 4 by 3. I'm sorry. When y is 0, either you may get x as 0. When y is 4 by 3. When y is 0, you may get x as 4 by 3. Right? So it is 4 by 3, 0. Right? See, what combination else left here? When x is 0, we took all these 3. When y is 0, we took all these 3. And then similarly, for x is equal to 0 in the second set, we took all the 3 equations from the first one. Then similarly, even for y is equal to 0 also, we took all this 3 in the first set. The only remaining combination is to select these two together. Correct? Now, I'm just taking those two together. Consider these two equations together. You see what they are? 4x plus 3y is equals to 3. Then 2x plus 3y minus 2, or else is equals to 2. Right? Now we need to just solve these two equations. Yeah. Oh, sorry. One correction here. When 4x is equals to 3, it is 3 by 4, right? So I have written it wrongly here. This is 3 by 4. Now see, we need to just solve these two equations. What we are trying to do here, you see, the same equations, you can write them like this. Shall we directly cancel these equations? You see, we can subtract one from the other. You see here, minus, and this is minus. Here also you'll get minus. Now see, you can just cancel these two. So it is 4x minus 2x. 2x is equals to, see, it is 3 minus 2, 1. From this, you will get the value of x as 1 by 2. Right, when x is 1 by 2, see, let us substitute this value of x in either of these two equations. So when x is 1 by 2, see how much it is when you substitute. I'm just substituting here in the second equation. 2 into 1 by 2 plus 3y is equals to 2. We got all the combinations, so I can erase this. Now, see, if I simplify this, we'll get 3y. See, here it is actually 1. When you send this one to the other side, it becomes 2 minus 1. So simply you'll get 3y is equals to 1, and that implies you'll get the value of y is equals to 1 by 3. So therefore, the next stationary point is what? 1 by 2 comma 1 by 3. So now see how many stationary points you got here? 3 plus 2 plus 2, totally 7. Not even 7, 6 only. Right? See, 0 comma 0 is repeated for 4 times. Right? So you can take it once, and then there are other 5 different stationary points. So I'm just writing all those things here. Therefore, the stationary points are 0 comma 0, 0 comma 2 by 3, then 1 comma 0, 0 comma 1, then 3 by 4 comma 0, and lastly 1 by 2 comma 1 by 3. Right? See, at this moment you can observe one point. Out of these 6 stationary points, in the first 5 stationary points, you got either x or y as 0. If you look at this, 0, 0, 0, 2 by 3, 1, 0, 0, 1, 3 by 4, comma 0. In these first 5 stationary points, you have at least one of the coordinates as 0. Right? So keep that in view. We have an interesting idea about that. Right now? Right. So now we got the stationary points, correct? After getting the stationary points, the next step is to evaluate what you call second order derivatives. Okay. So before getting into the second order derivatives, I'm just writing dou f by dou x and dou f by dou y for my convenience. See what it is. X square, y square. I'm just writing these two equations there. So we have dou f by dou x is equals to x cube y square multiplied by x square y square minus 4x minus 3y plus 3. See, this is dou f by dou x we have. Then dou f by dou y, it is x cube y multiplied by minus 2x minus 3y plus 2. Let's see, we have these two as what you call dou f by dou x and dou f by dou y. We can just use these two to evaluate what you call the remaining second order derivatives. Now see, I'm just considering the first second order derivative. It is L is equals to dou square f by dou x square. Right, so now we need to evaluate these three at each stationary point. Keep that in mind. Dou square f by dou x square. It is equals to, as we know, we write it as dou by dou x of dou f by dou x. I'm writing it directly, you see, dou by dou x of dou f by dou x. So we get it like this, x square y square multiplied by minus 4x minus 3y plus 3. Right now we need to simplify this. It is equals to, please keep concentration on this. You are now differentiating all this with respect to x. So I'm writing y square aside. Now see, it is just like x square into this bracket. As they are in product, I'm using UV rule. So keeping x square as it is. Now see, when you differentiate this with respect to x, we get minus 4. Next, plus, now I'm writing all this bracket as it is, minus 4x minus 3y plus 3. And the remaining there is x square. So when we differentiate x square, it is 2x. Okay. Now see, I'm just simplifying this. Y square times, we get minus 4x square, then minus 4x into 2x, 8x square then minus 3y into this, minus 6xy, then plus 6x. So then it is equals to y square times, if you add all these things, you know, we'll get 12x square minus 6xy plus 6x. Now see, can we take x common from these terms? You see, this has an advantage. So I'm taking x common from this, xy square minus 12x minus 6y plus 6. Right, let's keep this aside. Now let me just evaluate M. Now see, what is M? Let me just consider now, M is equals to dou square f by dou x dou y. Correct, so we can write this as dou by dou x of dou f by dou y. See how much we got dou f by dou y? I'm just substituting that here. It is x cube y multiplied by minus 2x minus 3y plus 2. Right, so then it is equals to, now again the same story, you see, we are trying to differentiate it with respect to x. So I'm keeping y aside, then see, it is like a uv, I'm keeping x cube as it is. So when we differentiate all these things with respect to x, we get it as minus 2, then plus, I'm writing all this bracket as it is, minus 2x minus 3y plus 2, multiplied by, you see what you have here is x cube. When you differentiate x cube, it is 3x square. Then it is equals to y into, I'm just simplifying this, you see, it is minus 2x cube, then minus 2x into this, minus 6x cube, then minus 3y into this, it is minus 9x square y plus 6x square. You see, from these terms, we can take what you call x square common now. So this implies when you take x square common, it becomes x square y. And see, when you add these two, it is minus 8, actually x cube, but already we brought x square out of this. So only 8x remains. Minus, here it is 9x square y, already we have written x square outside. So this is 9y and plus this is 6. Okay, now see, we got this as M. And now if you calculate N, what is N? You see, it is dou square f by dou y square. So we can write this as dou by dou y of, see how much it is? Dou f by dou y, I'm writing all this. X cube y multiplied by minus 2x minus 3y plus 2. So this is equals to, I'm now right differentiating all this with respect to y. So I'm writing this x cube as it is a constant, I'm writing it aside. Then y into, when we differentiate this with respect to y, we get minus 3, then plus minus 2x minus 3y plus 2. I'm writing all this as it is, and the remaining here is only y. When you differentiate y, it is only a 1, so I'm not writing that. And it is equals to x cube times, see what you get here, minus 3y, then minus 2x minus 3y plus 2. So when you simplify this, see what happens, you will get n is equals to x cube times minus 2x, see it is minus 3y minus 3y minus 6y plus 2. Right, so we got L, M and N in general. Now we need to calculate all these three things at each stationary point. But before moving to the next situation, let me just give you one point here. See, when we got stationary points, we have observed one point. Out of six stationary points, in the first five stationary points, we got either X or Y is equals to zero. Right, isn't it? See, these are the states. In the first five stationary points, we have either x coordinate or y coordinate is zero. Now see, look at now these three. Let us say first of all, L. Look at this L. In L, we have a product of these three terms, x into y into this. Now when x or y, any of those two are zeros, automatically, you know, it becomes like zero into something. So that automatically in the first five stationary points, the value of L becomes simply zero because of these products. Not only at L, look at this M. Here also we have X square into Y. So that at the first five stationary points, even M is also equal to zero, right? So understand what we are going to check after getting these three, we are going to evaluate ln minus m square, right? Remember, because there is no y here, n may not be zero every time, but as L is zero already, definitely this product is also zero. Though n is not equal to zero, L into n is also definitely zero. So at the first five stationary points, we are getting ln as zero, and even m square is also zero, because m is also zero, you see. Therefore, for the first stationary points, definitely we get ln minus m square as is equal to zero, right? So when it is equals to zero, you cannot speak anything about what you call, minimum or maximum, right? So you can simply say further investigation is needed. But there is only one other stationary point where we need to find out what you call these minimum or maximum, I mean extreme values, right? Let's just find out all those things. Let me just add a sentence about this, and then we'll proceed further. Now, I'm just writing a sentence of this kind. Therefore, for the stationary points, I'm just writing all the five stationary points at a time. For the stationary points, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 3 by 4, 0, one more is left. See what it is. 0, 2 by 3. Now see, for these five stationary points, L is equals to 0 and M is also equals to 0. Therefore, ln minus m square, this implies ln minus m square is also equals to 0. Therefore, further investigation, though they are stationary points, we are not getting either minimum or maximum at these five stationary points. Therefore, further investigation is required to find extreme values, not to find, to conclude extremum at these stationary points. Right? So we cannot speak anything about extremum or extreme values at these stationary points. Right? Now, there is one more stationary point, which is 1 by 2, comma, what is that you see? 1 by 3. Right? Now, at this stationary point, we need to see what we are going to get the values of L, M, and N, and thereby we can see whether we are going to get minimum or maximum at this stationary point particularly. Now see, at this point, 1 by 2 comma 1 by 3, see how much it is, L. I'm just substituting x is equals to 1 by 2 and y is equals to 1 by 3 at this point. See how much is L. It is now 1 by 2 into 1 by 3 whole square. You know, there you have y square actually. So it is 1 by 9 multiplied by minus 12 into x, 12 into 1 by 2, then minus 6y, it is 6 into 1 by 3. Plus 6. So this is equals to, or else this implies L is equals to, right? Let's try to simplify this. 1 by 18 times, see how much it is, minus 12 by 2, minus 6, then minus 6 by 3, it is minus 2 plus 6. See, 6 can be cancelled, you know, and remains is only 2 by 18 is minus 1 by 9. So this implies L is equals to minus 1 by 9. Right, let's keep this aside. Now, M, let us calculate the next value, M. See how much we got M. See, M is this, x square y. X square means 1 by 2 whole square, it is 1 by 4 into y is 1 by 3 multiplied by minus 8x. Minus 8 into x is 1 by 2, then minus 9y. 9 into 1 by 3 plus 6. And this implies M is equals to 1 by 12 times. See, it is how much? Minus 8 by 2, it is minus 4, then minus 3, 9 by 3, it is minus 3, plus 6. So this implies we get the value of M. You see, minus 4, minus 3, it is minus 7, minus 7 plus 6, it is minus 1 by 12. And then similarly, let us also calculate N. So then N is equals to, see how much you got? It is x cube. See, when it is x cube, x is 1 by 2, you know, 1 by 2 whole cube, which is 1 by 8 multiplied by minus 2x, minus 2 into 1 by 2 minus 6y, 6 into 1 by 3 plus 2. So then this implies n is equals to 1 by 8 times, see how much you are getting, minus 2 by 3 is minus 1, minus 2 plus 2. See, 2 can be cancelled and we get it as simply minus 1 by 8. So therefore, now you see if you calculate ln minus m square, it is equals to minus 1 by 9 times minus 1 by 8 minus m square. 1 by 12 whole square is 1 by 144. Right? 1 by 12 square is 144 here it is. Then how much you are getting, you see? 1 by 72 minus 1 by 144, which is equals to, you know, we can write this as 2 by 144 minus this is 1 by 144, which is 1 by 144. And anyway, it is positive. Right? And see how much you got L? It is minus 1 by 9, but see, this is negative. Therefore, see how much you got. Ln minus m square, we got it as positive, but L as negative. Therefore, the given function, see, when L is less than 0, we say the function has its maximum at the stationary point. So therefore, the given function has maximum value at, you know, this point, 1 by 2 comma 1 by 3. Right? So therefore, the maximum value, if you are asked to find this particularly, the maximum value is f of 1 by 2 comma 1 by 3. We need to just substitute 1 by 2 comma 1 by 3 in the given function. See how much is the actual function? X cube y square. I'm just substituting that here. X cube is 1 by 8 into y square is 1 by 9 multiplied by, see how much it is? 1 minus x minus y. So it is 1 minus x minus y. Let's see if you can simplify this. It is equals to 1 by 72 times 1 minus 1 by 2 is 1 by 2. 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3. It is 1 by 6. Right? I'm just writing it again. You see, this is 1 by 6. So therefore, you see, if you just simplify this, it is equals to, so that is the maximum function value which you get for this particular function. Right, now let's take this question. We need to find three positive numbers whose sum is 100 and whose product is maximum. Right, see, I'm just continuing it like this. Let x, y, z be the three required numbers. Right, so I'm just considering these three as the required three numbers such that their sum is 100. Right, so therefore you are now given x plus y plus z is equals to 100. Right, and now we want the product of these three numbers to be maximum. So we need x, y, z, you know, product of three numbers, this to be maximum. Right, so to maximize this, you know, we are given one constraint, right? See, whatever the function you are trying to maximize here, I'm just taking that function as f. So I'm just taking f is equals to x, y, z, you know, product of three numbers, and, you know, the other constraint. Let it be like this. I'm not going to use that anyway. Now see, from this equation, right, whatever you are given here, from this, we can write z is equals to 100 minus x minus y, right? Now using this constraint, we can reduce this function of three variables to a function of two variables. So then we can write f is equals to xy times 100 minus x minus y, okay? See, for my convenience, I'm just multiplying this. 100xy minus x square y minus xy square. Now, clearly, this is a function of two variables. So I can just differentiate f with respect to x, right? See how much you'll get when you differentiate it with respect to x. It is 100y minus 2xy minus 2x. This is only y square. Right? You are differentiating it with respect to x, no? So it is y square. Then, if you differentiate similarly f with respect to y, Now see, when you differentiate with respect to y, we get 100x minus, you know, when you differentiate this with respect to y, it is x square minus here it is 2xy. Right, now see, after differentiating these two, after evaluating these two derivatives, we need to equate them to zeros. So I'm just considering that part. So consider dou f by dou x is equals to zero. So this implies how much you get, you see, 100y minus 2x, I'm sorry, 2xy minus y square is equals to zero. Now see, from these three terms, you can observe, we can take a y common, isn't it? So when you take a y common from them, you can see we'll get 100 minus 2x minus y is equals to zero, right? So let's give a number to this. Let this be, if I take this as equation one, let this be equation two. Next, similarly, I'm also considering the other equation. If you take dou f by dou y is equals to zero, then this implies, you know, dou f by dou y is this. We get like this, 100x minus x square minus 2xy is equals to zero. Now from these three terms, we can take x common. So we get like 100 minus x minus 2y is equals to zero. Now let me take this as equation number three. Now see, the problem is to solve these two equations. See what you get from equation two. What can we write? Either y is equals to zero or 100 minus 2x minus y is equals to zero as their product. Similarly, from third equation, what you have, either x is equals to zero or this equation, 100 minus x minus 2y is equals to zero, right? Now see, again, as we did in the previous problem, we take one coordinate from first set and its equivalent value from the second one. Now see, if I, for example, if I take y is equal to zero from the first set, equivalent to this, I can take x is equals to zero, or I can directly substitute the value of y in this one. But see here, we want three different numbers such that their product is, we want three different numbers such that their sum is 100 and their product is maximum. But see, if you take one of these two numbers as what you call zero, either you may take x zero or y zero. If you take them as zeros, their product will be simply zero. As we know, we can easily find three numbers such that their sum is 100, but the product is more than zero, right? Product will be definitely, even if you take simply 1, 2, 97, even their product is more than zero in simple case. So definitely no one of these three numbers can be zero, right? That's how I'm not taking either y or x is equal to zero. So that the only combination remains is this. We need to just solve these two equations from which we'll get some stationary point, right? I'm just writing it as x or y cannot be equal to zero. I'm just considering only the remaining two equations. One is 100 minus 2x minus y is equals to zero. And the other one, 100 minus y minus 2x is equals to zero. I'm sorry, 100 minus x minus 2y is equals to zero. Right? Now we need to just solve these two equations. See, to solve these equations, I'm writing them again. This implies, I'm writing it like this. You see, 2x minus y, 2x plus y is equals to 100. I've sent these two terms to the other side simply. And from the second one, you see, I'm writing it like this, x plus 2y is equals to 100. Now simultaneously, if I multiply the second equation by 2, see what happens, 2x plus 4y is equals to 200. Right, I'm just rewriting the second equation like this. Now if I subtract one from the other, here also it is minus. See, you can cancel these two terms, and y minus 4y, it is minus 3y, is equals to 100 minus 200, it is minus 100. So from this, we can write the value of y as simply 100 by 3. Now, when you substitute this value in this equation, so therefore we get the value of x. As you know, if you substitute in this equation, we get it like this, 100 minus 2y, which is 2 times 100 by 3. So which is equals to, you know, this is also 100 by 3. So therefore, 100 by 3, comma 100 by 3 is the stationary point. Okay, now at this stationary point, we need to evaluate what you call second order derivatives to observe particularly where we'll get minimum or maximum, right? See, now for my convenience, I'm writing dou f by dou x and dou f by dou y again. Now see, I'm just using these two to evaluate the second order derivatives. So therefore, if I calculate L, as we know, it is dou square f by dou x square. As we know, we can write this as dou by dou x of dou f by dou x. See how much it is this? 100y minus 2xy minus y square. See, I'm just trying to differentiate this with respect to x. Now see, when you differentiate 100y with respect to x, it is 0. Minus when you differentiate 2xy with respect to x, we get it as 2y. And see, the next is also 0. So this implies, you can see, we get L as only minus 2y. Then similarly, if you evaluate M, it is dou square f by dou x dou y. This is equals to, we can write it as dou by dou x of what you call dou f by dou y. Then this is equals to, you know, dou by dou x of, how much is dou f by dou y? I'm just writing it here, 100x minus x square minus 2xy. Right, see, I'm just differentiating all this with respect to x. When we differentiate all this with respect to x, we get like 100 minus x square differentiation is 2x minus when we differentiate when you differentiate 2xy with respect to x, we get it like 2y. Right, so let it be like this. This is what m we got, and then n, it is dou square f by dou y square. And this is equals to, we can write it like dou by dou y of dou f by dou y. See how much you got dou f by dou y, it is 100x minus x square minus 2xy. So this is equals to, when we differentiate this, you know, for the first term we get it as 0, minus even for x square the derivative is 0, minus for 2xy we get it as 2x. So this implies we get n as what you call minus 2x. See, we got now L, M, N, all the three in terms of x, y. Now let us evaluate these three values at this stationary point, 100 by 3, 100 by 3. Right? Now see, at 1 by 3, or at 100 by 3, 100 by 3, at the actual stationary point what we got, I'm just calculating L, M, and N. See, L. See how much is L? It is simply minus 2y. So it is simply minus 200 by 3. Then M. See how much we got M? 100 minus 2x. 2x means 200 by 3 minus 2y. Right? 2y. 2y means, again, this is also 200 by 3. So this is equals to, if you just simplify this, it is 100 minus 400 by 3. So which implies, you know, M is equal to, if you just take LCM, 300 minus 400, it is minus 100 by 3. Okay. And if you calculate N, N is, look at it, minus 2X. So it is minus 200 by 3. X is 100 by 3, you know, that's how minus 2X is minus 200 by 3. Therefore, if you just calculate now LN minus M square, see how much it is? L and N, they are same even with negative sign. So when you multiply them, we get it like this, 200 by 3 whole square minus m square. See, m square is this, 100 by 3 whole square, right? So definitely you can see, even without calculating the actual value, you can observe we have higher value minus lower value. So definitely this is positive. And if you look at the value of L, right, L is, we got it as minus 200 by 3, and see, it is negative. Now see, when we got ln minus m square as positive and L as negative, certainly we can say the given function f has maximum right? At, you know, this point. 100 by 3 comma 100 by 3, you know, when I'm writing these things. 100 by 3 and y is equals to 100 by 3. Now see, when these two are x and y, and then corresponding to these two, what is actually z? See, the equation what you are given is this, x plus y plus z is equal to 100. So z is this, 100 minus x minus y. I'm just substituting x and y there. So it is 100 minus 100 by 3 x minus 100 by 3 y. So this implies we get z as also equal to 100 by 3. Right? So therefore, the three numbers, see, we got maximum, in the sense product is maximum, correct? So therefore, the three numbers whose sum is 100 and whose product is maximum. Right, are these three numbers, 100 by 3, comma 100 by 3, 100 by 3, right? That's it.